دن 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 دن. مرحبا، اهلا وسهلا بكم في الطبخ السعودي. انا اسمي ايمان. Hello everybody, welcome again to another episode Saudi Food with Iman. A lot of you have asked me to make maqluba, so I'm going to show you how to make it. Are you guys excited?
Yes.
Maqluba means upside down. It's a dish where we make it with rice and vegetables and we put it in layers and we turn it upside down and we serve it. Popular in a lot of Arab countries, popular in the Middle East, but each country makes it in their own way. I'm going to show you how to make it the Saudi style. So are you ready to do another Saudi dish with Iman?
Yalla!
So we're going to add 2 tablespoons of oil, 1 diced onion, 1 diced small bell pepper, 1 tablespoon minced garlic, 1 teaspoon salt. So now we mix it all together, and when you roast it, it gives it a very nice flavor. So now it has become a bit light brown. We're gonna add the chicken. Put the skin side down, so we're gonna brown it from the skin side. Gonna add a pinch of salt, black pepper, Saudi spices. Cook it till all the sides are white and not pink anymore. So now the chicken has become brown. All the juices and the oils from the chicken came out. We're gonna add the water just to cover the chicken. We add 1 teaspoon of salt, spoon of Saudi spices. We will add 2 dried lemons. They're in brown color and sometimes they're in black. If you can't find it, don't add it. Usually find this in the Arabic store or Indian stores as well. Pinch of black pepper, green diced onions. Cover it and let it cook on medium high heat for 15 minutes. We need 1 onion, about 2 or 3 black eggplants, 2 pieces of potatoes that have been sliced. This is the thickness that we're looking for. 1 tomato sliced as well. Green bell pepper. Cut the eggplant. You need to clean off the head and the bottom. We dice the first side, very thin layer. This is the shape that you will get. It's like squarish shape. Cut it into thick pieces. The red bell pepper, cut it in half. Remove the inside. Cut it in 3 parts in half. So we bring a pan on medium high heat. We add a little bit oil. Let it heat up, frying the eggplant. Once it has become gold light and brown, we turn it around. You remove it. Fry the sliced potatoes. Come gold light brown. Cook the cauliflower. Cut them all in half. Once it has become golden brown, you put it in the strainer. So we add all the sliced eggplant side down. We're gonna turn them all around to the other side. Fry it for another 2 to 3 minutes. Now we will remove it and put it aside to cool down. A little bit of oil in the same pan. We're gonna add the bell pepper. We're gonna let it roast in the pan till it gets cooked. That will take around 10 minutes. So now it has browned from one side. We're gonna turn it around. We're gonna keep it on the other side for another 2 to 3 minutes. Now it has browned on one side. We're gonna mix it a little bit. Remove it and put it in the strainer. We will add our sliced onions. So now our onions have browned a little bit. I'm gonna turn it all around. Add the sliced tomatoes. You don't wanna cook all these vegetables for a very long time. You want them browned and golden brown, but half cooked or a little bit more than that. So now the chicken is ready. Remove the chicken from the pot. Add a little bit more salt. Add 2 cups of basmati rice that have been washed and strained. We're gonna keep it for around 7 to 8 minutes. We let it cook on medium heat. In the same pan, we're gonna add 135 grams of tomato paste, a little bit of salt, around 2 pinches, 1 or 2 pinches of Saudi spices, 1 pinch of black pepper, 1 tablespoon of oil, little water, and mix. You don't want it too thick and you don't want it too watery. Now this is ready, we put it aside. Now I cook this for around 7 to 10 minutes. It's half cooked. Now we're gonna prepare the maqluba. We have the vegetables that we have fried, we have the chicken that we have boiled, and we have the rice that we cooked for around 7 to 10 minutes. I've divided them in 2 halves. The first thing we're going to do is take some salt and sprinkle it on top of the vegetables. Take the tomato paste we have prepared and we add it to the first half of the rice. Mix it slowly so you don't break the rice. The second half of the rice, we're gonna take 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. You mix it all together. Now we're going to prepare the maqluba. Put it in layers. It's extremely important that you do this neatly. Add the skin of the eggplant at the bottom, face down. Make it like a shape, like a flower. Add little of the potatoes, just a few of them. Then we add the chicken in between, cauliflower in the side. Then we add the remaining potatoes. Add the bell pepper on the side. I try to make 1 green, 1 red. Make sure you really focus on this so the dish would turn out to look nice when you serve it. Press it a little bit, add the red rice, press it down, tomatoes, onions, the eggplant. Make sure you fix it properly on the side. We add the yellow rice, even on all sides, and we're going to press down. You don't want to push too hard. I'm going to add the remaining chicken stock. We will cook it on low heat for 20 to 40 minutes. It's been around 30 minutes and now we are ready to serve. How are we going to serve this? Basically, we're going to open the pot. We need to turn it upside down. Put this underneath. We're going to bring a flat pan on top, my hand underneath it. So turn it. Center it, so we do it from the side so it doesn't stick to the bottom. Keep it like for 1 or 2 minutes to make sure that everything comes out, and we're gonna see what's going to happen. So 1, 2, 3, and when you pick it up slowly. So now this is the final dish. Look at this.
It even looks yummy before you even taste it.
Fahad's gonna try it and he's gonna tell us what he thinks.
Good. It's legendary.
It's legendary. This is how we make maqlooba, Saudi style. Bilhana wa shifa. I hope you enjoy it. See you next time.
Bye. Subscribe.